Hello students. So in the previous video, we have seen the basics of computer graphics, the introduction part, and what are the course outcome as well as the course objective, and what are the different topics we are going to learn, and the definition as well as the importance of the computer graphics and the applications of the computer graphics, and what are the different components are used in the computer graphics, right? So in this video, we are going to start the display devices. So what are the different video display devices are used, and what are the two different types of display devices are vastly we are using in the computer graphics? That is nothing but the random scan display as well as the raster scan display, right? So the display technologies. So the very first thing what we are going to discuss is CRT monitor. Right, so the CRT is nothing but a cathode ray tube. So this is considered as a very common graphics output device. Okay, so the video monitor, whatever video monitor, for example, some 20 or 25 years before, wherever we are seeing in all the houses, we will be using only the CRT monitor. But nowadays, which is replaced with the LED display as well as the LCD display as well as plasma, right? But the cathode ray tube, to understand more about the computer graphics video display devices, we should learn about the CRT, right? So here in this diagram, the functionality of the cathode ray tube is explained. So if you see this diagram, actually here we are having the base part. So the base along with the connector pins, which will be connected to the the power supply, the electricity. Then to this electron gun, the electron beam will be produced. Okay, and here we are having three different types of plates. The very first one is the focusing system. Suppose the electron gun, which is always producing the electron beam, it should be directed, right? So to focus the electron beam, which should be actually penetrated through the phosphorus coated screen, right? So for that purpose, here we are using two different depletion plates. The very first one is called as horizontal depletion plates, and another one is called as vertical depletion plates. Okay, so the electron beam which is touching this phosphorus coated screen, obviously it will be producing the particular image or the picture, right? So here the electron gun, this is considered as the primary component of the CRT. Okay, so the electron gun, which will be directing by the connector pin, which is connected to the electricity, means the current, a beam of electrons which will be emitted by the electron gun, which should be passes through the focusing system as well as the depletion systems, right? So here we are having two depletion plates. See, the beam is passing through this horizontal as well as the vertical. Otherwise, it'll just scatter, right? That's the reason we are having these three focusing systems. Okay, so the focusing system's main role is which is used to force the electron beam to converge into a small spot as it strikes the phosphorus. Okay, that is the main use of the focusing system. And here we are having horizontal as well as the vertical depletion plates. Okay, so what is the use of this plates means? Because it is used to mounted horizontally to control the vertical depletion, and vertically to control the horizontal depletion, right? And the beam which is passing through these depletion plates, which will be positioned directly to the phosphorus coated screen. Okay, so then the phosphorus, wherever the electron beam is touching the particular screen, which used to emit the small spot of light at each and every position which is contacted by the electron beam. So if it touches for the single time, so only one blink we used to get, right? But if we want to see the entire image, then automatically the CRT screen should be refreshed, right? Then only we can see the stable images or the pictures, right? So for that purpose, we are using the refresh CRT. Okay, so this is used to keep the glowing, which is again and again used to redraw the picture repeatedly by quickly directing the electron beam back over the same points. Okay, so that's why it is called as refresh CRT. So the CRT monitors it is using two different types of techniques. The very first technique is called as raster scan display, and the another one is random scan display. Okay, by the name itself, it implies raster scan means which is using the frame buffer. And the random scan means by the name itself, it implies randomly it will touch any of the point in the screen and it will start produce the pictures, right? Yeah, let us see one by one. So the very first one is raster scan display. So here the main aim is the electron beam which is directed to the screen should be it is used to draw more number of scan lines. Okay, so the scan line is nothing but it should cover the entire monitor, the video monitor, from the top to down, from left to right. Okay, so the from top to down, in the sense, see here in this diagram, the from top left corner to by using the horizontal retrace, again it is touching the next left point to the right point until it reaches the final, means the last part, means the end of the screen. Okay, once again it should refresh, it should get refreshed, right? So by using the vertical retrace, again and again the scan line will be repeated to get the entire image. So if you see here in this particular image, for the very first line, one pixel is getting enabled. And for the second scan line, two different pixels are getting enabled. So in this way, the entire image we used to get by using more number of scan lines. Okay, so this process is called as rasterization process. Okay, otherwise all these lines are called as the scan line. Okay, so this diagram implies the horizontal and vertical retrace of the raster scan display. So let us discuss the architecture of the simple raster system. Okay, so here all the IO devices are connected to the system bus, and through the system bus we are connecting the processor as well as the system memory and the video controller, which is directly connected to the monitor. Okay, so this is the very simple raster scan. So here the video controller is used to send the images to the monitor. And the system memory used to hold all the pictures or whatever the images, right, to be displayed. And next level, the architecture of a raster system, along with the system memory, we are having the frame buffer. So already we know what is frame buffer, right? So frame buffer is nothing but it is a matrix of zeros and ones. So the group of zeros and ones will be there. So wherever the particular image is there, only those particular pixels will be get enabled, right? So that is called as a frame buffer, right? So here also we will be using the scan line to find out the particular object. So here the frame buffer is directly connected to the video controller. Okay, so from here the monitor will get the final image which is to be displayed, right? And next one is this diagram is actually along with the display processor. In the previous two diagram, we don't have, that is called as a very simple architecture, but here we are having the separate display coprocessor. Okay, so what is the difference between previous diagram with this diagram? Means here the system bus is connected to the processor, system memory, along with the display processor. Okay, again the display processor is having its own memory. Okay, because for a rasterization process, again and again to refresh the scan lines, more memory will be, actually we are in need of the space, more space, right? For that purpose, here we are having the different display processor memory. Along with this, we are having the frame buffer. Okay, so then the frame buffer will directly giving the images to the video controller, and this will give the particular image to the video monitor. Is this clear? So this is the architecture of the raster graphics system with the display processor. This is important question, because we are having two different architecture, without display processor and with the display processor. Okay, so and this display processor is known as a device controller also, right? Okay, and next comes the random scan display. So the random scan display is otherwise known as vector scan display or calligraphic display. Okay, so by the name itself, it implies random scan. So electron beam is randomly, it touches some point, from there it will start analyze the points, okay, the pixels. So you know what is pixel, right? So pixel is nothing but it is a very small element in the monitor, means in the display screen. So it is called as a picture element. Okay, so that's why it is pixel. Picture element is called as a pixel. Okay, and each and every pixel will be having the value zeros and ones, right? And here the architecture. So here the architecture is very simple. So the system bus is directly connected to the processor, and system memory along with the display processor to the monitor. So this is a very simple random scan. Here there is no need of frame buffer and all, because it is a random scan, right? So the display processor will directly give the images to the monitor, right? So so that's all about the display, video display devices. So we have studied about CRT, random scan, as well as the raster scan. And next to some of the hard copy devices of the computer graphics. So which is considered as a printer and plotter. Printers is used to means a very small small amount of pictures or images can be taken print out. But if you want any architecture or very big diagram, means by the time we'll be going for the plotters, right? And these are the different input devices for operator interaction. So through this input devices, easily we can go for the computer interaction to make the interactive computer graphics. Okay, so it can be any keys of the keyboard or mouse clicks or trackball or space ball or joystick, gloves, digitizer. Okay, so these are the some different input devices used for interaction. So that's all about the this particular part, right? So in the next video, I will explain you the OpenGL basics, right? Thank you.